Good evening. We've got extreme weather affecting eastern and western parts of the country. There'll be heat moving in from the interior towards New South Wales and parts of Queensland. And we've got a couple of fronts that are going to bring widespread thunderstorms and damaging winds to the southwest of Western Australia tomorrow and Monday. Now, you can see a little bit of the imprint of this on the satellite image. Firstly, in the southeast, we've got some cloud cover. Now, this is the trough that's bringing in some odd showers at the moment. And then this is the cloud that's representing the cold front that's approaching the southwest of Western Australia. Now, let's have a look at what the synoptic chart is doing, and you'll notice that there is a high-pressure system which is keeping skies clear across most areas tomorrow. There will be a trough bringing some showers and storms across the southeast, another that's going to bring some showers to areas of Tassie, Victoria and southeastern New South Wales, and then here you can see this large cold front crossing the southwest of WA. For Queenslanders, though, tomorrow we'll be seeing some showers south of around Townsville and then isolated thunderstorms south of Bowen. So that includes Brisbane tomorrow with 26 degrees. Elsewhere, it's sunny and very warm, particularly through the west. Mount Isa heading for 36. So tomorrow, elevated fire dangers across most of the state. New South Wales, we've just got isolated showers and possible storms through the southeastern corner and also during the afternoon across the north coast. But anywhere else, it'll be dry and sunny. That includes Sydney and Newcastle with temps in the low 20s. Victorians, we're seeing isolated showers and storms moving over the state, basically clearing out of the east during the afternoon. So for Melbourne, it'll mainly be during the morning, then a partly cloudy afternoon with 21. Some showers clearing from the south and west of Tasmania. So similarly for Hobart, morning showers and then a dry afternoon with 15. Just the chance of showers through the lower southeast of South Australia for somewhere like Mount Gambier. Everybody else, though, remaining dry tomorrow across the state with 22 degrees for Adelaide. Southwest WA tomorrow, widespread showers and thunderstorms with heavy falls and damaging winds likely, so make sure you prepare for that. A scorcher through the interior with 37 for Alice and another sunny day for Darwin. Let's now check out the next week of weather at your place, starting off with Brisbane, and we'll be seeing sunshine from Monday through to Thursday, a possible shower on Friday and then showers on Saturday with 26, and they will be quite substantial. Sydney, it is going to be dry and sunny for another week with a temperature peaking towards the middle around Wednesday, Thursday. There will be a cool change later Thursday, so the temperature dropping to 23 degrees on Friday, but essentially you can do your washing every day and if you can, head to the beach during the middle of the week. Canberra, sunshine on Monday with 23 degrees, dry again Tuesday, Wednesday and then a possible shower with a cool change on Thursday. For Melbourne, sunshine but very windy on Monday with 25, just a possible shower Tuesday, Wednesday and then substantial showers with a change and a much colder 16 degrees. For Hobart, we'll be seeing a possible shower Monday, dry on Tuesday and then Wednesday, Thursday, once again some isolated showers. But notice the temperature dropping on Thursday to only 15. For Adelaide, we're looking at dry skies until Wednesday and then much cooler Thursday with showers and southwesterly winds. Perth, severe weather Sunday and Monday with widespread showers and storms. Damaging winds are likely. Darwin, meanwhile, beautiful as usual with temperatures of around 34 to 35 degrees. That's all for now, Hermione. See you tomorrow. Okay.